Bring it back to the middle and round again. Whip it up, shake it down, slide it back on in. Alright. Alright. Knocking on a hardwood like I know you should. You'll be shaking on a kitchen floor.
Kitchen floor.
Cooking up your TV dinner. Sunday afternoon center. Turn it on. Turn it on. Switch it on.
Can I get an angel up in here? I'm crying, save me.
As we all know, television and film has influenced fashion, but the L Word has gone beyond inspiring a look. It has literally turned fashion on its head by creating a unique collection of jeans, accessories, jewelry, and apparel.
Hanging on the back of the beat, hope the soles on my feet hit the ground.
Labrador, and welcome to L Word's Elements of Style. We're going to take you on an inside look into the inspiration of the unique fashion created by Showtime's groundbreaking series, The L Word.
For three seasons, the women on Showtime's deliciously soapy hit series, The L Word, have seduced, struggled, and shocked their way into our hearts.
You do know that we're lesbians, right?
Their provocative stories and quick wit.
I happen to be the Earth Mother. I would have been the godmother, but I don't believe in God.
Have made them as much a part of our pop culture landscape as they have our TV sets.
We're all connected through love, through loneliness, all of us.
And now, let me take you to the set of The L Word in Vancouver to meet its costume designer, Cynthia Summers.
I had an interesting interview with Italian L, which was interesting. They had said in their caption something to the effect of, if Sex and the City was the fashion catalyst for the East Coast, then Cynthia Summers and the L Word is the fashion police for the West Coast. And of course that was like, wow, that was like huge kudos for us. One of the most important things that, from a style point of view, that we're trying to put forward with the L Word is individuality. We're trying to take from the core group, expand on it, amp it up, give it a fashion sense, and then get individual with it and bring out personalities. Well, welcome to the world of the wardrobe closets. We're going to start off today with Bette's wardrobe. Oh my God, I wish I could wear what Bette wears to work. It's my fantasy. If I only had the body, I would definitely wear that to work. She's the alpha female of the group. Bette's our suit girl, our sort of office girl. We've got one really gorgeous Dolce & Gabbana suit with a sort of a tuxedo top, a bit of a vest back going on. And Bette goes out and she goes out in style. A little bit of Roberto Cavalli. Signature Roberto Cavalli. And Bette's always good in white and off-white, winter whites. Gorgeous silk Jean-Paul Gaultier blouse that ties very, very this current season. And then we paired it with a beautiful high-waisted, big belted skirt. And that gives us a little bit of Bette's softer side. A little bit of Burberry overcoat with a little bit of a sheen to it. Gorgeous Burberry. She has probably one of the most extensive shoe collections. A beautiful pair of Miu Miu's, one of her evening outfits. We all love shoes here. These may have been her favorite shoes this season, but these YSLs, they were a huge hit. We've got some D&G, Dolce & Gabbana, men's style brogues. The last pair of shoes we had for her that were a real big hit were these Dries Van Noten's. Lots of bags, beautiful BCBG, Max Ezria bag. Oh, yes, and Bette, and her Gucci. We got into the vests and the capris, the short pants this season with her, and vests. And anything sheer and flowing, Jennifer was really happy with this season. And now we're in Shane's closet, a place where I know a lot of people would like to be. Shane's probably evolved the most out of all the characters and stayed
true to the core of who she is. She started out looking very rock and roll, looking very Mick Jagger, you know, 70s sort of rock. Shane's wardrobe, Dior. It was Dior all the way. She's wearing a lot of Dior home. In fact, practically mostly Dior home. The jackets, the ties. One of her staples, of course, is a jacket. Beautiful, double-breasted, men's Dior jacket, pinstripe. And underneath, a really gorgeous tuxedo shirt. These are the tuxedo pants we built for her way, way, way back at the beginning that we seem to always wear. Super skinny, super flattering, made to measure for her. Sometimes she pairs it with a Dior belt, Dior men's belt. Sometimes we do it with a white one as well, but I don't see it here, which means I think I know where it is. We all know Shane wears a lot of jeans. The jeans come and go, and the jeans are the things that change constantly. One pair we wore last year were the Frankie B's. Always skinny, always tight, always low rise. That's Shane in a nutshell. Another band shirt, sort of a knockoff band t-shirt. Morphine Generation. She does wear a lot of Morphine Generation shirts. We just quite often will cut the sleeve off and make it a little bit more Shane. Then we go to her little boy's side. Always the Converse. The Converse pretty much are glued to her feet most of the time. We picked up some really nice, really cute, fun little striped shirts from Dior as well. A little polo neck, short sleeves. And for all of you fans that truly, truly watch the show and watch it really closely, you will notice the Gucci ring that Shane has been wearing from the very, very beginning. And oh, popping up here for a sec, the boots. The Daytons, the boots that started the whole thing right at the beginning. They've kind of subsided for the Converse in the last few seasons, but they do make an appearance every now and again, and sometimes she lends them to her very best friends like Alice and Jenny.
Knocking on hardwood like I know you should, or you'll be shaking on a kitchen floor.
With Showtime's The L Word, first of course being one of their biggest fans, but I actually, through Love and Pride, got the opportunity to participate in this promotion. So they wanted to do a special merchandising promotion for the launch of the fourth season.
I'm Woody Bear, and what I do is I design jewelry. I designed the L Word collection last season. This year we're launching a very exciting line. Elemental style, and I'm designing the jewelry part. I really didn't believe it. In 2 weeks, we met the entire Showtime team that we're gonna get it, and suddenly I found myself doing the L Word collection.
I'm Laura Dahl, designer of the L Word collection. I was approached a few months ago with this amazing opportunity, and was asked to design, you know, sort of a mini collection for the launch of season 4, and I was thrilled to do it. Put some things together, and I guess they were fabulous.
I want to be the John Lennon of the jewelry industry. Not just write beautiful songs, but write songs that have a message behind them. My message to the L Word collection will be beauty, strength, liberty, love. You know, the show is so inspiring because it deals with personalities, with people, first of all. Happy to be women. And the L Word collection celebrates women's strength, women's freedom, liberty.
I really wanted for the regular public, for anyone, to be able to take home a piece of the L Word. And having said that, we designed some great, easy, washable, fabulous designs that are going to be available at a price point that many people, you know, can afford to take home with them. And of course, keeping in mind the characters, and they were very inspirational in this. Another thing I love about what I've been able to create in this brand is being able to reach, I think, a lot of different females of different ages, of different backgrounds, and lifestyles. But there is a little bit of everything, I think, for all of them, really. And I would love the opportunity to dress them.
These are our charmers that I did for the collection. You'll see that I was able to find some very L Word, literally, charms.
An incredible dress, slash tunic.
Which these days, you know, it's all about skinny leg trousers and jeans as well as leggings. This garment is fabulous on. You can belt it or not. And yeah, I think this is a really special piece for that super chic fan.
These actually are washers. So metal washers, hardware being kind of
thing, but this is very unexpected because it's literally the thing that when you make an eyelet, which is a hole in the garment, the washer is on the inside of the garment, so you never see it. We wanted to bring it on the outside and dress it up and make it a little fun, so fill it on with your stilettos and a fabulous jacket and you're ready for anything.
First of all, living in LA, jeans are part of the uniform. My inspiration for the jeans, of course, being a fan of the L Word, is that there are so many wonderful, rich characters. So I chose four characters that I felt represented four very different personalities and types of women. And the characters that I chose were Beth. She's really the professional, polished woman, so I wanted to do a jean that was a trouser cut, something that a professional, she's a museum curator, could wear to work in a dark wash, a little bit of a flare, and something that was really fashion forward. The next character, of course, you can't do anything for the L Word and not do Shane. She's the independent spirit, a rock and roll kind of rebel girl. So I wanted something like a low rise, something cut down low, a little distressed look, and of course, lots of pockets, because it's for the woman who might not carry a purse. Kit is a character who's seen the world. She's been there, she's been back, been to the rodeo, and you know, I felt like, you know, the real woman, you know, is a curvy woman, and fashionable, wants to look good. And so I wanted a style that actually had, you know, like flat pockets, something with a little stretch, really kind of accentuated the womanly shape. And so that's why I really wanted to do a kit. The fourth design is based on the inspiration of my personal favorite character, who is Dana.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Elements of Style.
Bring it back to the middle and round again. Whip it up, shake it down, slide it back on in. Alright. Alright. Knocking on hard wood like I know you should. Or you'll be shaking on a kitchen floor.
Kitchen floor.
Cooking up your TV dinner. Sunday afternoon center. Turn it on.
Turn it on.
Switch it on.
Can I get an angel up in here? I'm crying, save me.
Welcome back. I'm Honey Labrador, and this is Style Network's look into L Word's Elements of Style.
The L Word had a groundbreaking storyline last year when Dana was diagnosed and ultimately perished from breast cancer.
Do you have a favorite character?
Dana, and she's gone. Of course, I didn't know last season that her character would have such an impact on my life this season, because I was only diagnosed a couple of months ago.
And I think that all of the designers, we all felt that it was important to tie everything that we were doing into a charity.
Nikki's actually a spokesperson for breast cancer awareness.
I did a lot of work for the Clement Foundation this last year, the Warriors in Pink.
So it just made sense, you know, and when I created the Dana, everybody kind of said, oh my gosh, let's all create one piece that we give the proceeds to breast cancer research.
It just created a great garment that a lot of people, I think, will be interested in. This is the Dana piece, where all the proceeds will go to the breast cancer awareness. Again, a fabulous dolman sleeve, very easy to wear with leggings or full trousers, pretty much for any body type. You can wear it on the shoulder or off the shoulder, very conservatively or not. The fabulous crystals, of course, are what make it extra special. And of course, we had to add in the fuchsia for the elbow.
100% of the proceeds we got to work at breast cancer research is this collection that we did now. This part is all limited edition. It will be numbered. When it's gone, it's gone. And we can do a lot of beautiful things that will benefit cancer research, breast cancer research. Again, we're using alternative metals here because I want it to be affordable. So a lot of stainless steel, a lot of stainless silver. In a regular L-Word collection, we have 18 karat gold and stainless steel silver. In the limited edition, I want to use alternative metals. I want it to be affordable. I want to create something that any elfin, woman, or man can buy.
The Dana Jean. A top from Laura Dahl. Piece of jewelry from Love and Pride. All of the proceeds from the sales of these three items will go to the Susan Komen Breast Cancer Foundation and the Dr. Susan Love Research Foundation.
And Showtime is very involved with those two foundations, and I'm very proud to be part of it.
I think what you're doing is extremely generous, and not only because of the money that you're donating, but the fact that you actually designed this line, the Dana jeans, and that, you know, that you're putting your money where your mouth is, in the sense that you're giving back.
Join me as I take you on a behind-the-scenes look into the process from design to manufacturing. This is where we take from my very remedial drawings to a more graphic picture, and then we spit out a pattern. They just come out on this little pattern machine. These jeans are actually 15 pieces of a pattern that are then cut from a raw denim product. The denim that we're using is Italian denim. There's a 2% lycra in it, so there's a stretch. So they retain their shape, you know, you can wear them over and over and over without washing them. What's amazing is that all four styles of this jean come from the same fabric. So we have a different wash for each jean. Patty's holding here, we've got the chain. So in order to get from this color to here, it goes through a wash process, and then there's actual sanding and grinding. All of these little details, which would take you 20 years to wear them in,
There's actually somebody who stresses them for you. We also have the kit, which has a wonderful little detail here. What are those called again?
Whiskers.
Yeah, so we have little whiskers. And this is also done in the wash process. So it gives you texture, and it's actually got a little bit of a slimming effect. So rush out and get these. So this is what you have, from raw product to finished product. Okay, so here we are in the embroidery room of Jean Martin, and this is where all of the little finishes and pockets. This is the back pocket of the chain before it actually gets sewn on. So the embroidery stitching goes on. Jean, I got Jane in here. Goes on. Joe, how are you doing today?
Thank you.
So what are you working on?
The chain pocket, as you can see, the embroidery process for our back pocket.
This is really embroidering, Joe. I mean, you just push button and it happens all by itself. It'll get sewn onto the back of the jean, and this is the finished product.
The chain tag.
We can do one size run if you want.
This 31 right here.
It sounds like my closet in the year's run. I go from a 27 to a 31.
Now they get through the rivets and the buttons. So what they do is they make a standard, and it has all the rivets, and then we list all the tags and everything. So after they put the rivets on and the buttons and the zippers, then they go and tag them and bag them and box them, and then we ship them.
So as I said, it takes a village. All these machines, all that sewing, everything you hear, they're making it all happen. Hey, you guys, there you are. Steve and Jasper, these are my boys. How you doing?
These guys are actually the masterminds, and I have to say, they made my dream happen, so I can make your dream happen.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Elements of Style. back. You're watching L Words, Elements of Style. You're here at Global 61 with Terry Batocchio. Terry, how are you?
I'm doing great, thank you.
I'm very excited that in Los Angeles we now have a store which is carrying all of the collection. You've got the tops from Laura Dahl, the amazing jewelry from Love and Pride and Indie Bear.
And the Annie L. Designs jeans.
Talking about how TV has influenced fashion, what do you think about the fashion of the L Word?
I think it's perfect, and I think the L Word is translated fashion into the streetwear.
It's really great to see that some of these designers have picked up our looks and made them, as I said, streetworthy.
These are great jeans.
It's great. It's like kids and candy in a candy store, and I feel like, you know, the candy queen.
I think it's influenced greatly people in their own styles.
I want the chain jeans. Many things that the kid jeans look better on me.
TV has always done that, you know. Mm-hmm. It's always leading a little bit what fashion is going to be.
I think these are my favorite.
I think this show is a pioneer of sorts, the whole, everything about the show, and I'm just really proud and happy and honored to be part of it.
I mean, just to be asked is incredible, and I know we're doing some beautiful things all of the time, but this collection really was special to me in that regard.
Laura Dahl, who has done like an amazing tops and clothing line, which is, this is actually her stuff.
I'm completely flattered that I've been seen as a pioneer as far as the show inspiring other people. I don't think that's sunk in yet.
For me as an artist, and especially what I'm doing, with the Edward collection, is a dream come true. And it's everything, I think, everything an artist can dream of.
And Love and Pride, they do wonderful jewelry, and it was a lot of fun. Your hopes for this collection for you?
Hope he flies out of the store.
Yes, I had a great time. Thank you for joining me for this behind-the-scenes look into the L Word culture. Not only has it inspired so many women, it has inspired a fashion culture. So please go check out our designs, and until next time, we hope to see you in the L Word. What is your favorite L Word?
Hola, la mula. Oh, my goodness. Yes.